Welcome everybody. In this video, I will be reviewing a few stocks that were asked by our members in our info year live stream. Starting off with Ashok Leyland. Ashok Leyland is an auto stock, and currently auto stocks are not in favor of the current market. The stock is holding a broad range that is between 100 to 137, and it will take a long time for the stock to break this range. Only if the price breaks out of this range with significant volume, the stock can enter into its next journey. Volumes are also getting lower, and with it, even the average volume is also getting lower, which means there are no buyers nor sellers. Ashok Leyland is not a good stock to buy now. If you're holding Ashok Leyland, you need to make a choice whether to hold a non-performing stock or to move to a strong stock which can give better gains. To sum it up for Ashok Leyland, if wanting to buy, it is not good to buy now. If holding, it is better to think about an exit and move into better stocks. The next stock is Intellect. Intellect is an SRR qualified stock since June of 2020. It has gone to give more than 500% returns since it had qualified in its top rank. Stock was in consolidation from May 21, and now it has broken out of the slumber where the stock had a very good breakout entry last week with volume. And when breakouts come with volume, stocks can continue to run up. And we have seen that in the stock here. Last week was the breakout, and this week is again gone up with big volume. Now, as the stock has gotten into a new high with big volume, patterns are developing big weakness. We need to be cautious and have profit booking below 745. So now the question is, will it come to 745? We can go to daily and see. On daily, the stock is building strength, which should keep the stock up for some days. So to sum it up for Intellect, not good to buy now, while if holding, it's good to take a profit booking below 745. The next stock is BPCL. BPCL is one of the stocks that did not participate in the market run. It has built a significant weakness at the top, though the stock is trending. BPCL had a very strong trend reversal buy this week in lower time frames, where we can see here it is doing very good. Coming back to weekly, price is at the buy level, while as the stock has developed weakness, it is only good to take a small exposure in BPCL. If holding BPCL, it's good to look at a maximum profit booking and move into better opportunities in the market. To sum it up for BPCL, if wanting to buy, it's only suitable for short trades. If holding, can think of a maximum profit booking. The next stock is BSE. BSE is also an SRR qualifier, and we had done a business story video on BSE, which you can watch by clicking on the link that's coming up on the right hand corner of the screen. BSE has given a very good run since it had qualified to the top ranks. As the stock is going up, it has huge support. This week it has a down close, while on lower time frames we can see that the stock is coming down without volume. This means that the sellers are less in the stock, which can keep the stock price up. So not good to buy now. There is some potential for some correction, which can build into a range. So buying will be good only when the range breaks with volume. If holding, need not be in a hurry to sell. To sum it up for BSE, if wanting to buy, have to wait for a correction. If holding, can continue to hold, no need to be in urgency to sell. Next stock is HFCL. HFCL is again an SRR qualified stock, and it has given amazing returns from the time it qualified. On this big green bar where I'm pointing my crosshair is where it qualified. And we can see the run the stock had, but there's a slight problem in this stock, and that is that we can see this blue bar where it has given back all the gains of the previous week. When this pattern comes, it is called as a railroad pattern. This pattern will show that the stock will remain or go into consolidation going forward, and this is what we can see in this week's bar. The stock is also having an amazing pattern where there is no volume as the stock is coming down, which means investors not willing to sell the stock. So when a stock comes down without volume, it will go back up again. So coming to, if you want to buy a stock, HFCL is not a good to buy now at such a high price. It can buy when it corrects a little bit. If holding, need not worry, it has a long way to go. To sum it up, HFCL, if wanting to buy, it's not good to buy at such a high price. If holding, need not worry, it has a long way to go. The next stock is Britannia. FMCG as a sector is not favorable currently, and Britannia has been non-trending since 6th of November 2020. We can see what a non-trending stock does. A non-trending stock will only try to remain in the same range, and it keeps going up and down in the same range. This is why investing in non-trending stocks are not recommended, because they like to play around in the range they have formed themselves. So to coming to, if you want to buy, if wanting to buy is not a good stock to buy now, while if wanting to buy for lifetime holdings, then consolidation like these where the stock comes down is giving a better opportunity to accumulate the stock. Coming to, if you're holding the stock, you can make a choice if you want to stay invested in a stock that will have very slow price movement and slow growth, or invest into a very good and aggressive stock for trading. So to sum it up for Britannia, not a good stock to buy now, and if holding, can think of whether you want to take exit and move into aggressive opportunities in the market. Next stock is Reliance. Reliance's result was wary, and the stock has been non-trending for the whole of 2021. We can observe that this big drop in volume and also the volume average, which means overall the market is not interested in the stock. If Reliance has no volume, market will also not have a very significant volume in it, and that's very evident in many stocks not having many volume at all. Coming to, if you want to buy Reliance, it's a non-trending stock, and as I've discussed for Britannia just before this stock, non-trending stocks like to play in a range of their own, so it's not good to buy non-trending stocks. If holding, we should make a choice if you want to hold a non-trending stock or move to a better opportunity in the market, because non-trending stocks will not give quick returns, and this view is only for the short-term investors. So to sum it up for Reliance, if wanting to buy, it's good to stay away. If holding, can think of moving from a non-trending stock. Next stock is TVS Motors. TVS Motors this week has given a bearish trend reversal. A bullish to bearish trend reversals usually take time, and we can see in this red bar here, which came in 23rd of April. It is also a trend reversal, but it failed. You can see the bar, that next bar with huge volume of stock has gone up. The reason for this bearish trend to fail is because the stock had good strength at that time. Now if you see, a trend reversal has come without any strength in the stock. When a trend reversal comes with there's significant weakness in the chart, it's not always a good sign. So not good to buy now, and if holding, it's good to take an exit. The next stock is Infosys. Infosys had a good result while the stock has been up for a very long time now. When you're out in the sun for a long time, you'd want to come back in for some shade. Looks like the same is happening with Infosys too. Because as we see, the MACD and the histogram are building significant weakness as the stock is going up. With this being the pattern, Infi can keep slowly inching up while it will not give great returns, but the time consumption will be huge. So a good stock for those who have patience. Okay, I repeat, for those who have patience. It's not good to buy now, and if you're holding, it requires immense patience. If you have patience to hold, then we can continue holding it. To sum it up for Infi, not good to buy now. If holding, it requires patience to make money. The next stock is Alkylamine. Alkylamine this week has gotten a new high, but without any volume support. The stock has broken its consolidation phase and is gone up. And Alkylamine was also an SRR qualified stock. It qualified back in May 2020 and it gave 400% returns. Now the stock is out of its rank and has also built significant weakness. Buying now is not a good choice. So if holding, can think of having a maximum profit booking and stay light. So to sum it up for Alkylamine, buying now is not a good choice. If holding, can take maximum profit booking and stay light.